Okay, hello everyone, and welcome back to some MKX. You're probably watching me absolutely fail at this game on screen because I have not played in a long time. However, I needed to get some footage, and this game is the most appropriate because we are going to be talking about MK11 today, whose reveal is only 2 days away, and surprisingly, it's actually at a time where I can watch it, and I can give you some reactions and my opinion once it's done, so you know. Gonna be starting to pump out the MK11 stuff. Not that the game is, well, 4 months away, maybe? Yeah, 4 months. It's coming out in April, so super hyped. As you know, the boy loves MKX. So, yeah, in this video, I'm gonna take the opportunity to talk about some of the things I've gathered five. Some of the things that I would really, really like to see them include or not include in MK11. These are just my, like, hopes and wishes, I guess you could say. But I don't know. Hopefully there is some consensus within the community that some of these things are needed. I've seen people talk about these things, so hopefully I'm not just talking out of my ass, you know, and this is something that will be looked into because again I've seen a lot of topics and discussions on some of these things. So yeah, let's just jump right into it. So the number one thing I would really like to see is the implementation of an actual proper ranked system. I think both Injustice 2 and MKX suffered from this problem where the leaderboards were extremely well hidden and interpreting them was very difficult, combined with the fact that there was no visual feedback in ranked mode. So technically, there was not much point in playing ranked at all because, again, you beat someone and you don't even know what happened. You don't know if the guy was 300 spots above you on the leaderboards or 500 spots below you. You don't know if you ranked up, you don't know if you got demoted. Again, there was absolutely no visual feedback. And again, because of that, like, what even was the point of having a ranked mode? So, if you look at every major fighting game, it has some type of ranked system. Whether it's Street Fighter V, you know, bronze, silver, gold, whatever. Dragon Ball FighterZ has one. Tekken has one. Again, every major fighting game has one. So, MK11 really, really needs one. It would be really good to have some type of feedback on kind of the level you're at, and it would actually make sure that people get matched against people who are in their level or in their group, because MK had a problem where, you know, even now sometimes when I play occasionally I get matched against people who have, like, you know, 13 wins and 50 losses and they're like level 11. So, you know, an actual ranked system would really help kind of bracket players into their own groups. The number two thing I'm hoping for is for the run system to return, but for it to be reinterpreted. Now, I know the run system is controversial, however, I think it's actually something very unique that MKX had going for it. It is really the thing that makes it stand out from other fighting games, you know, like run canceling, especially run canceling. That's one of my favorite mechanics of MKX. Not only does it lead to huge combos, it's good for, like, pressure. It's a really good show-off move, you know, to do, like, run cancel combos and all that. So, yeah, the running system is absolutely something that I like. However, the reason I say it has to be reinterpreted is because running was just way, way too strong in MKX. Essentially, most of the characters had amazing runs, and most of the characters could just, like, you know, bam, be in your face instantly and apply pressure. This was one of the reasons why MKX really did not have too many varied playstyles, because just running was way too strong. So how to change it? I don't know. However, I would like to think that maybe have the runs be shorter, you know, that you cover a shorter distance. Or maybe if you can cover a longer distance, have the runs be slower, more like the Soul Calibur speed, you know, where sure, you can get in quickly, but it's not like instant, you know, and your opponent can react. So I'm hoping it returns, but I'm hoping they tweak it a little. Number three thing, building off of what I said previously, I'm really hoping that there will be more varied playstyles in MK11. I think the being able to select your own moves mechanic will probably help in that, if all of the moves are balanced. However, the reason I say more varied playstyles is because both Injustice 2 and both MKX had one type of gameplay style that was viable. In Injustice 2, it was projectiles and zoning, in MKX, it was rushdown. All day, rushdown, rushdown, rushdown. Whether your character had amazing overheads and lows that they could convert to combos, or your character had amazing pressure, Liu Kang, where he could just like be in your face all day and you won't even be able to escape. Again, what I mean by more varied playstyles is I want viable zoners, I want viable rushdown characters. You know, there's nothing wrong with rushdown characters. You need some, otherwise your game would be boring. Just, you know, switch it up. I would really, really love to see a proper grappler character be included. I know Commando Kano was there, but the grappler playstyle, I think, is really underutilized in NRS games, and there's so much you can do with it. I think probably Bane was the best grappler they ever made, so I'm hoping they're gonna include something like that in MK11. Number four thing is gonna be something that I don't want. I really, really don't want there to be hard to blockables in MK11. This was a thing in MKX. They're called hard to blockables. I think it's kind of a shitty name. It's not my favorite. However, essentially what it is two moves that hit overhead and low very, very close together, almost at the same time. The reason they're not called unblockables is because technically they're blockable, but you have to be essentially an AI or have superhuman reflexes or just get lucky to block them. Now, specifically the character that comes to mind when you mention hard to blockables is Summoner Quan Chi, where he could just like loop you and kill you with his nearly instant overheads and lows. That's not fun. Even with a character I like, such as Tremor, he could do the rock toss and then hit low. That's not fun. Like, when you're being kind of beaten out by a move that is impossible to avoid, or set of moves that is impossible to avoid, because even an unblockable move, like to build off of Tremor, the Tremor ground pound, sure, it's unblockable, but if you get hit by that, it's really your mistake, because that move is like very slow, super telegraphed. However, hard to blockables, they do not fall into this category, because it's essentially like, I guess, like an exploit to the system of the overhead low system. Yeah, again, I would really, really like to avoid hard to blockables if possible. And finally, the fifth thing, if the game is going to be pressure focused like MKX, I really want there to be ways to escape from pressure, actual real ways to escape. Now, I think this is something that we might get if the game does go in this direction, because Injustice 2 had push blocking. I think push blocking was one of the best inclusions in Injustice 2. It's viable, it happens quickly, it doesn't take too many resources. So, you know, instead of a block breaker, which, but you know, really, did anyone ever use block breakers viably in MKX? No one used them, because simply they just cost too many resources. Instead, push blocking, you know, it gets your opponent off, but it doesn't push them too far away. It's not too cheap. I'm really hoping that it's going to be included, just again to make the playstyles, the aforementioned playstyles, more varied and more viable. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed. Really, this is just my two cents, so feel free to disagree, feel free to let me know your opinions, and I guess we will find out at least partially how much of what I said here will be true when the reveal happens in 2 days. So yeah, thanks for watching, make sure to like, comment, and subscribe, do all that good stuff, and yeah, thanks for watching, and see you next time. Goodbye.